Welcome back to a new series called Protip. Why Protip? Because the other series FNA is for new animators, and I want to do something where it's after you graduated and you are about to get a job, in the midst of a job, with tips that might help you through that process. And why now? Because I finished teaching all my animation classes at the academy and people are graduating or about to graduate, and I wanted to say congratulations, that's awesome, good luck to you, and here are a few tips. All right, so the first tip or the first piece of advice or the first thing you need to know when you enter the animation industry as a professional in any kind of field for games and feature animation or VFX or VR, anything you need to know, this industry sucks. There you go, I said it. It's a tough industry to get in. The hours suck. The comments on your work can suck. They can make your work worse. You might not get paid enough. You're gonna get laid off. Even getting a job in this current climate with the pandemic and the lockdowns, are there any jobs out there? And even if you get a job, what if your boss is horrible? What if you get into a rhythm of working too much and they don't pay you overtime and the company closes and doesn't pay the last paychecks that you're supposed to get for the last few months? It sucks. This industry sucks. Why am I saying this? Just because every time someone posts something positive about this industry, comments come in and they complain, why the fake positivity? This industry sucks. And this person is right. It does. This industry does suck. I've been working for almost 17 years. Every year for those 16 to 17 years, every summer, I had to face layoffs. Sometimes it was just kind of just talked about. Sometimes it was very close. Sometimes you get into forced vacation and you don't know if you're going to get a paycheck next week. Every year for almost 17 years. Sometimes you work for 6 months on the show and then 80% of your work gets cut. You got nothing to show for and your demo reel is at that lower level, not with the newest work that you wanted to present. You might also work for years and years and years and you think you do good work and you ask for a raise or promotion and that gets denied over and over. This happens. This happened to me and it sucks. This industry sucks. You think you do good work and then you hear that companies are colluding to keep the salaries low. That sucks. You hear of your industry heroes that have paved the way, that have created crazy technologies, that they are abusers and harassers. That sucks. You might get hired at the company on a project basis, and that's only for a couple months, and then they string you along each week. Oh, maybe there's an update, maybe not. You get laid off. You don't know if there's a next paycheck. Can you pay for your apartment, for your house? Can you provide for your family? If you can even have a family, because if it's on a project basis, you have to move all the time. That sucks. Is the company you want to work for in a city that's really expensive, and the rent and housing prices go up and up and up? That sucks. You didn't have to move out to commute for an hour or longer to get to your job, less time that you can spend with your family or your friends. That sucks. You're actually going to spend more time at the company than at home with your friends or family. That sucks. So congratulations, you graduated and you're headed into the industry. That sucks. Now, is that helpful? No. Is that the reality? Yes. Is my reality your reality? Of course not. Sucks for me, but it's still better than for many other people. You want to cringe at the politically correct thing that I'm a white male? Well, but it's still a fact. It sucks for me. It sucks much harder for other people. So there you go. For everybody that comments, that wants to hear that it sucks, there you go. These are the facts. There are many other. This industry is hard. It's hard to get in. It's hard to stay in. It's different level of hardness for other people, and it sucks. And if this is the first time you're hearing this, now that you've graduated, that sucks. You should have been told this a long time ago by your teachers. So why am I still doing it after 16, 17 years? Because I love it. Does it suck? Yeah, of course it does. But it's also something that I'm okay at. I don't know what else I could do. And you have to work hard. Every summer, I have to think about layoffs and work on my reel. I constantly have to train to get better so I can justify my demands for raises or for a promotion. There are people who get hired years after me who are much better, much faster. I have to keep up with that. But that is the reality. Does it suck? Yes. My wife, she worked in textile design. Guess what? It sucked. Company closed, overseas outsourcing these companies until the company in America closed. Now she's doing sales. Guess what? It also sucks. I have friends in other countries with totally different jobs. And guess what? They all suck. And they do. And I'm not even saying this to be dramatic. These are all facts. Everything you're going to do has an absolutely horrendous side to it. So the question is, and this is the question for anybody doing anything, from being a carpenter to an essential worker to an animator, that's definitely a spoiled job. Is this something that you're good at? And not from a technical point of view in terms of animating, but is this something you can go through? Because you're going to be told no over and over and over and over. You're going to get into situations where there are going to be confrontations, where your demands are not met, where you're going to get disappointed. You might get a job at your dream company and then you hate it. If you remember the Janet Chan clip, she worked at DreamWorks, was awesome, then worked at Disney and it was horrible. And that's a fact. And that's not her being dramatic and that's not me downplaying it. It sucked. And then your decision can be to be an entrepreneur and to do something on your own. And guess what? Comments for that also suck. Oh, you want to be an entrepreneur. You want to do your own job. You want to create your own business. Well, guess what? This is going to be hard, blah, blah, blah. So being a worker bee sucks. Now being independent sucks. Being an entrepreneur sucks. You're going to get negative comments comments all the time. Are they valid? Yeah, but also depends on what you're going to do. All those things that I've listed, they are true. Things happen to me, things that I heard. It just sucks. It's a hard industry. Right now, the industry is on a lockdown. Like, there's nothing you can do. There are layoffs coming. Absolutely. There's less work. Absolutely. This sucks. So you have to decide if this is something you want to do, because you can't get into the animation industry thinking it's going to be great. You're going to have your own office that you can decorate. You're going to get the best shots ever. You're going to get your Annie Award. Maybe you're going to direct a movie and get an Oscar. Like, these are outliers. And even those people worked really hard. You have to work really hard. I know someone who was at Disney, where you think that's the best job ever, who still got up way early in the morning to work on a reel to go with another company. Even though you think that person wouldn't have to, that person still had to work really hard. So that's my rant. I have actual tips for you when you graduate, but I wanted to front load that with, yes, this industry sucks. And there's no way around this. And you have to hear this. You have to know this. You have to research where you're going to live, where you're going to work, what the company culture is, and if this is going to be something that works for you. You can't believe the advertisement of schools and companies. So whether it says it's going to be great, the making of where everything looks happy. For some people, it is happy. And guess what? For those people, it still sucks. And that level, of course, is going to vary. Just like I said in the previous clip, there is a scope of it. I have been fairly lucky with what I've gotten, but I've worked really hard. And there's a lot of stuff that none of you know that I have done to be there, to get there, and to stay there. Now, you might do the same thing and you will still not get there, and it's going to suck much harder for you. And again, that is the reality, and that is not to be downplayed. That's a fact. It's not going to be fair, and it's definitely not merit-based. As with everything, there's going to be a massive combination of you working hard, being recognized for it, but also luck and timing and at the mercy of managers and all kinds of stuff like that. So, congratulations, and I'm sorry. It's great. It's a great job, and I love it. And at the same time, you're headed into an industry that is very, very difficult. So if you're discouraged, that's a valid feeling. Again, double check, triple check. Is this something you want to do? Now, if you heard all of this and you've heard of this before and you've been warned and you know what? I'm ready. This is a tough industry, but I love the art that I'm doing and I have that creative fire in me. I want to do this. And again, every industry has their horrible sides and you got to fight through this. If you're still into that and you want to get going, here are my tips. So now that everything's on lockdown, CTN, SIGGRAPH, not sure how that's going to move forward. So you have to be a self-promoter and put your stuff online. So as you have your reel, you graduated, you should apply at all the companies, but don't just do that. It's 2020, you have to be a self-promoter. Put your stuff on LinkedIn, put your stuff on Twitter, put your stuff on Instagram, wherever you can, and showcase what you have. If it's not ready, mark it as a work in progress. If it's a specific reel, make sure that it works for that company, but still put that stuff online, market yourself, go out there. You never know who sees it, who might recommend and forward your shot to someone who might hire you. Now, if you have questions about demo reels, I have a whole series, link in the description and up here. Watch those series. Hopefully those tips will help you. After everything I said, watch out for your expectations, right? So as you send your reel and you get in, make sure you really research that company, the culture, how are the people, what's the work environment, what are the hours that are asked of you. So really research and check your expectations so that you're not crushed when something happens that you did not expect. But just like with everything, you have to work hard. You have to work hard on it over a long period of time. And sometimes it's earned, but don't expect to be given things just because you work hard. It's just, that's not, it's again, it sucks. It's not fair, but that's just how it is. So you're gonna have to do always extra work. And this is, again, my perspective, and it's gonna be different for other people, easier and harder. Like I said, you're gonna spend more time at the company than at home. So choose your company wisely. Now choose quote unquote, because if you are graduating, you probably have no choice. You're gonna have to get the first job you can get to pay your bills. If you are in a position where you might have multiple offers, and that is a privileged and very special opportunity, think hard, where do I want to go? Do I want to go there just for the company's prestige? But does that come with long commutes, a weird culture? Like, you have to make a lot of decisions, so research your company. Now, you graduated, you got that interview. Don't forget that you should ask the company questions. You are providing a service to the company. Don't work for free. Don't go, I want to do everything for you. They're going to take advantage of you. So as you're there, ask animation questions first if the Adam Soup is in the interview, because that person is busy. So you can ask questions like, if there's an Adam quota, are you going to do the whole scene as an animator, or just foreground, or just background? Is there a fixed animator position? Is there a background animator position? What do you do in terms of responsibilities? How much do you share with your team, and so on? Ask animation specific questions for the person who's in the room. So that way, when you're done, that person can go and get back to work. Then ask your HR questions. Do you pay benefits? What kind of benefits? Do you pay for sick days? Do you pay vacation days? What kind of medical benefits are covered? To how much? Is it 50%, 80%, 100%? If you have to relocate, do they help you with relocation costs? Are you hourly or salary? Do they pay overtime? All that stuff you have to ask. And don't forget, you are providing a service to them. They need you, so this has to also work for you. Of course, all in the context of you working at a company, within a team, for someone. It's a completely different environment than your school environments. Things are not going to be given to you. There's going to be a different workflow, a different hierarchy, a different pipeline. So wrap your head around that. So when you start working on your shots, don't expect those shots to be on your reel. You're not working on your reel. You're working on the client's reel. It's someone else's vision. You're working for that person. Whoever is in charge who wants that short or that movie done, they will have specific ideas about their shots, and you have to do the best you can to make those shots work for that person. Because you are providing a service now, this is a production environment, and if you want to do something where you have more control, then you got to do that at home, on the side, or change a job with different responsibilities and different job title. Like, depends again, depends what you want and research that. But be aware, if you want to work for a company and you're working for someone, this is in a team environment working for someone. Now, if this is the first job you're headed into, just know that the work you're doing for that first job might not be available for your reel because the movie's not out in theaters yet or streaming or whatever, and you can't show work that hasn't been out for you to rip and put that on your demo reel. So if a movie's not out in theaters, you can't use that work. So be ready, if that's your first job, to still work on your reel at home. You still have to work all day, come home, work on your personal stuff to create another reel that's not your school reel, but it's more of a newer reel, but still not the professional work that you get from the movies or TV shows or whatever you're working on. So be ready for that on your first project, that the timing is going to be weird and you might not get that material for your demo reel if you need to go for your second job. Because you might get a job, but this could be project-based for 3 months, 6 months, a year, you never know. So be ready for that. Now, know that when you're in school, it's all about animation, you learn the principles and you work on your technical aspects and mechanics, performance, that's all cool. That's about half of what you're going to do at work. The other half is going to be navigating the work landscape. So you have to work on your social skills. So you have to be able to talk to production, navigate dailies and clients and notes and deadlines. And you are dealing with people in an expensive environment with a lot of stress, a lot of egos, a lot of creativity. So you have to be able to put your own ego on the side, work for that person, still find a way to get your creative voice heard without causing conflict. There's a lot that goes with it. And to me, as I always tell my students, it's like high school with more money. You're gonna have cliques, you're gonna have groups, you're gonna have weird infighting, you're gonna have egos. But again, you are working in an environment with very creative people with strong opinions involving a lot of money. So be aware that this is the environment you're heading into. That being said, don't compare yourself to other people, because again, your situation is unique and your goals are unique and your struggles are unique. So I would try to get a 5 to 10 year plan. I know this sounds ridiculous, but how can you have a plan for next week, especially given this current climate? But if you can, if you start at a company and you want to stay there, you want to do your career there, look at what is the lead animator doing? What is the supervising animator doing? What other skills have they learned to get there, to get the promotion? And then start working and practicing and training to get towards that. You can't just work and imagine you're gonna be an animator there for 20, 30 years. That's not how it works anymore. So you have to look at, if I wanna make a career at that company, what are the steps to climb up the career ladder? And the reason why I'm saying don't compare yourself is because there are people who are gonna get there faster than you, and some people are gonna get there slower than you. Again, based on whatever individual situation they're in. So try to have a plan and stick with it. Because if you're constantly comparing yourself to other people who are getting there faster than you, who are better than you, it's gonna get just depressing. Like, oh, why not me, why me, why me? Then you're back into what I said at the very beginning, it's just all negative. And I just don't buy into that. Yes, this industry sucks, but at the same time, there's also a ton of good stuff. The work is great. The people are great. The creativity is awesome. The stuff that you create and how you influence people in theaters, you inspire people. There's a lot of really cool stuff in this industry, and this is why I'm still doing it. Now, do I ignore the bad stuff? No. Do I want to linger on this and do all of my clips every time going, this is going to be hard and it sucks? No, but what's the point? It is hard and it's going to suck. And that's everywhere. Every job, everything in the world out there is not fair. And it's going to be hard. But is that as motivating as me telling you these are the tips that you can use to get there maybe faster, to navigate this in a maybe easier way? Here are animation tips and tricks to get you better at your craft, to move and advance forward faster. That to me is more valuable than constantly focus on the negative and constantly go, this is horrible, horrible, horrible. Even comments on my channel. Like, I don't see the point. You can't ignore the negatives and you have to work on those negatives. But at the same time, there are positives and they're going to be different for other people. So I prefer to focus on the positives, so you can strengthen that aspect while you still work on the negatives. So speaking of the negatives, one of them is your health. So you might be pumped and you're motivated and you work really hard. Watch out your wrists, your back, your elbows, your eyesight. Stay healthy. Sometimes you get into a crazy flow and you're so good at it and you forget the time around you. And that day after day, year after year, takes its toll on your body. So make sure there is a balance where you work hard, but also rest. But ultimately, like I said, it is a business. So as you get in there, and even if you're successful, successful and it's going to be awesome. Have a plan B. Have an exit strategy. You never know what's going to happen. Company might close. Suddenly something happens, the pandemic, you have no job. There's always something that might threaten your stability. So keep working on your reel. Keep practicing. Keep training. Think about your savings. Think about your insurance. Think about your retirement. And maybe long term, think about starting your own business, like I said before. And some people will complain about that. Just, I don't know. Like, you can choose if you want to listen to them or not. Obviously, like I said many, many times in this clip, there are pros and cons. But at least if you get into the animation business and you love it. Enjoy the ride. Be aware there are going to be negatives, but it's still a fantastic job. And compared to what other people have to do in this world, it's a massively spoiled job. At the same time, be ready for a plan B, for an exit strategy, because it's not always going to last. And my last tip is, don't listen to anything I say. This is my perspective, my point of view. This is a massive scope of what people are dealing with. And I might be somewhere that for you is horrible. You never want to do this. You don't work for a big company and be a worker bee. Or you don't want to stay at the company for that long and you want to do something else. You want to do freelance. You want to be more creative. You want to have your own voice. That is absolutely valid and more power to you. Again, this is what I experienced. This is what I have learned. And hopefully this is helpful to you. There are tips that I've heard from other people who have had other experiences. It's a kind of a combination of everything, but still all through my lens, my subjective point of view. So take it or leave it. This might be too negative. This might be too positive. You can never please everybody. But if you graduated, congratulations. Good luck. Hopefully all those tips will help you. I have more links in the description with working from home, with staying motivated, demo reels. So I have more things around that might hopefully help you. And of course, I'm going to end with a plug. If you just graduated and you are about to get a job or you want more training, so you're ready for that job. I do have workshops. Yes, this is a shameless plug, but I do have those workshops for a reason so that you can continue your training. So link in the description, you can sign up at any time. If I can help you with strengthening your reel to get a better position, that I would love to do that. So let me know. You can sign up at any time. Let's work together. Other than that, this was a long rant. Hopefully it's helpful. It's a bit of a reality check, but also still, I am still doing this because I love it. So even though there are many negatives and you look online, you look at what people talk about in terms of their experiences, you got to listen to that. You can't just listen to all the positive stuff. You have to listen to the negative stuff and you have to filter that and look at how does that apply to me? Do I really want to get into this industry when I'm faced with all of that pros and cons? And this is all very subjective and you have to make that decision for you. But do not ignore the negative comments. Don't just listen to the positive comments. I absolutely 100% agree with that. And complaining about it all the time also doesn't help. So is this something that's going to work for you? That is ultimately up to you. And again, if you graduate, congratulations. If you have any other questions, email me, leave a comment. I want to help you as much as I can. Good luck with everything. Have fun and see you in my next clip.